Hey everyone, today we're going to review the parts of a box plot and talk about how to create a box plot. So yesterday we learned about box plots, that they show five different values of our data. Okay, so we have the minimum value, which is also called the lower extreme. Okay, so that's the smallest number in our data set. Then we have the lower quartile, which is also quartile one. Okay, then we have the median. Okay, the median is quartile two, so that's the middle of our data. Okay, and then we have quartile three, which is also the upper quartile. Okay, and then we have our maximum value, or sometimes called the upper extreme. So these are the five data points that are shown within our box plot. Okay, and remember, since it's split up into quarters, okay, all of our data is split up into sets of 25%. So from the lower extreme to quartile one, that's the first 25% of our data. Okay, from quartile one to quartile two, or the median, is the second 25%. Okay, quartile two to quartile three is the third 25%. And then from quartile three to the maximum is our last 25%. And we see that it equals 100% of our data. Okay, and then one other thing that we get asked about is the interquartile range. Okay, so the interquartile range, or sometimes called the IQR, okay, is the range of the box. Okay, because the box is our two interquartiles, okay? So we have that 25% and 25%. So our interquartile range is the middle 50% of the data. Okay, so if you were analyzing it, this middle 50% is where you're most likely, okay, going to be able to predict what maybe the next values would be or how much you would have. Okay, so the interquartile range is going to be the range of the box. All right, so now let's talk about how to create a box plot. Okay, so here we have our data. Okay, when we're making a box plot, okay, remember we need to find the minimum value, corridor one, the median, quarter three, and the maximum value. Okay, so what we have to do is we first need to put our numbers in order from least to greatest. Okay, so 4, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 13, 15, and 20. Okay, so I see my minimum value is 4. My maximum value is 20. Okay, and now we can find the median. Okay, so remember, the median, we're looking for the middle number. Okay, so if we go through to look for the middle value, we have one number in the middle, 11. So 11's our median. Now to find quarter one, okay? What our lower quartile is we have to look at the bottom 50%, okay? So the bottom half of our data, okay? So these four numbers here, we need to find the median of those values, okay? So the middle of the bottom half. So if we get rid of 4 and 9, we're left with two numbers in the middle, okay? So we do 7 plus 8 is 15 divided by 2 is 7.5. And then we do the same thing to the upper quartile. Okay, so the upper quartile is the top half of the data. Okay, so then we have our values between 13 and 15. 13 plus 15 is 28, and half of that is 14. So now that we have the five values needed, we're just going to plot them on our number line. Okay, and then we'll talk about how to make the box. So the minimum is at 4. Quarter one is 7.5, so in between 7 and 8. The median is 11. Quarter 3 is 14. And the maximum value is 20. Okay, so we're just going to bring all of those dots just above the number line. Okay, and so our quarter 1 and quarter 3 is going to make the box. The median is our line in the middle. And then we connect the minimum to quarter 1 and quarter 3 to the maximum. And there we have a box and whisker plot. All right, so now you'll go back, complete the assignment for today, and we'll see you next time.